In this problem, we're dealing with an enzymatic reaction that involves inhibition, and in particular, competitive inhibition. And we're given some basic information about the rate at a certain inhibitor concentration, and then when the inhibitor concentration is doubled. All right, so competitive inhibition, as I've just circled, is when an inhibitor binds to an enzyme to form an enzyme-inhibitor complex that cannot participate in the reaction, cannot catalyze the desired reaction of converting substrate to product. And so we'll want to be able to account for that in the Michaelis-Menten mechanism. So let's go ahead and write out what the Michaelis-Menten mechanism is again. So we have enzyme and substrate reacting to form an enzyme-substrate complex, which can go back and form the enzyme plus substrate, as shown by the reverse arrow, or form the free enzyme plus the product. We can write the rate of this reaction, right, in terms of a maximum rate or maximum velocity times the concentration of substrate divided by the concentration of substrate plus a Michaelis constant. And so this is the classical Michaelis-Menten form that takes into account the fact that our enzyme can become saturated. Furthermore, we can modify this in terms of the effect of an inhibitor. In competitive inhibition, the rate expression follows this kind of relationship where changes in the inhibitor concentration affect the second term in the denominator with the Michaelis constant. This term K sub I that we've introduced is basically an equilibrium constant describing how much free enzyme exists compared to inhibitor-bound enzyme. Standard way to write it is that it is equal to the concentration of the reactants divided by the concentration of the products in this binding of the inhibitor to the enzyme reaction expression. And we then go back and look at our given information, and we see how the rate has changed as we have changed the inhibitor concentration. And we see that initially the rate is 1 mole per minute, and we are also told that we know that the concentration of free enzyme is much greater than the concentration of the enzyme substrate complex. Okay, this means, if this is the case and we have lots of free enzyme around, right, it means that we're in the first order kinetic regime. Right, and so these terms in the denominator, where we have concentration of substrate, we expect that is going to be very low relative to the Michaelis constant, and so therefore we'll be able to neglect it in the rate expression. All right, so we can remember that these two terms in the denominator, the concentration of substrate is a larger term at high concentrations of substrate, where there will not be much free enzyme because all of the substrate will be bound up with enzyme. And then the second term, the Michaelis constant, will become relatively more important at low concentrations of substrate where there isn't much substrate-bound enzyme, so we have lots of free enzyme. And we're told in the problem statement that we have lots of free enzyme. And so we expect that this second term, the Michaelis constant, is what will dominate, and so therefore we'll neglect the first term. Right, in other words, saying that there's a high concentration of free enzyme is another way of saying we have a low concentration of substrate. All right, that's what keeps our enzyme free. All right, so let's take a look at our two conditions. So the reaction rate under condition one is 1.0 moles per minute. And then we just fill out the rest of the Michaelis-Menten expression here. We'll write a similar expression for the second higher inhibitor concentration, where we're at 0.8 moles per minute for the rate. We're at the same substrate concentration. Km is just a constant, but now the inhibitor concentration has doubled. So we'll have a 2 times concentration of I here. And we'll refer to this as I naught to give it a constant value. Now there are several ways to work with the algebra here, but one thing that we can do is divide one expression by the other. So we'll divide the first expression by the second one. 1 divided by 0.8 is 1.25. And then the reason we do this division is a lot of terms are constant and cancel between the two expressions. So Vmax is a constant, the concentration of substrate is a constant, and the Michaelis constant is also a constant. When we collect terms, then we get a 1 plus 2 I naught over Ki divided by 1 plus I naught over Ki on the right-hand side. And so we have one equation in terms of one unknown, which is our inhibitor concentration over Ki. And so we can just solve for that. And so we get that the inhibitor concentration I naught over Ki is equal to 1/3. Now what we can do is we can plug in, we know what this value is, and so we can plug this into either of our relationships. I've chosen the second relationship above, and we can solve for the lumped term Vmax times concentration of S over Km, which will tell us something about how, in the absence of inhibitor, the reaction, how quickly it runs. All right, so if we just plug in that value of 1/3, then we can solve for this collection of terms, Vmax times concentration of S over Km, is equal to 1.33 moles per minute. All right, so we're interested in the rate when the inhibitor concentration is zero, and that is just the classical rate associated with the Michaelis-Menten expression under conditions where we have lots of free enzyme, so under conditions where we can ignore the concentration of S in the denominator, and therefore the rate is just equal to Vmax times the concentration of S divided by Km. And so our rate is 1.33 moles per minute. And so we can see in this problem, really what we did was we used information about the rate at a couple of different inhibitor concentrations, right, and the fact that we had an expression for the rate in order to solve for some unknowns inside those expressions to solve for some of our kinetic parameters. Right, the first of those, because we were given two inhibitor concentrations, was we were able to solve for the effective inhibitor constant Ki, right, in terms of this value I naught. Right, and then once we had that, then for either of these rate expressions, we could solve for the rest of the constants as a collected term. And it turned out that those constants had a physical meaning, right, which was what the rate of reaction is in the absence of an inhibitor. This allowed us to solve for what we were asked for in the problem statement, was that if we cut the inhibitor concentration to zero, what would the rate of reaction be?